Welcome you all. Myself Professor Shilpa Rao from Gekewa College of Pharmacy. Today we are discussing distribution law. If we take two immiscible solvents A and B in a beaker, they form separate layers because they are immiscible in nature. When a solute X, which is soluble in both solvents, is added, it gets distributed or partitioned between them. Molecules of X pass from solvent A to B and from solvent B to A. Finally, dynamic equilibrium is set. At equilibrium, the rate at which molecules of X passes from one solvent to another solvent is balanced. If you see this diagram, this is the solvent A, this is the solvent B, and when you add this solute X in these immiscible solvent, there is a partition of this X in solvent A and solvent B. The solute X is distributed in these two solvents, and the concentration of the solute X in A solvent and B solvent is constant. Means ratio of the concentration of solvent X in A solvent and concentration of X in B solvent is constant. Now we'll see the statement of Nernst distribution law. If solute X distributes itself between two immiscible solvents, that is A and B, at a constant temperature, it is very important, at a constant temperature, and X is in the same molecular condition in both solvents, then ratio of the concentration of X in A solvent to concentration of X in B solvent is represented by KD, that is the distribution coefficient. If C denotes the concentration of solute in solvent A, and C1 denotes concentration of solute in solvent A, and C2 denotes the concentration of solute in solvent B, then this Nernst distribution law can be expressed as C1 upon C2 is equal to KD, that is the concentration of solute X in solvent A and concentration of solute X in solvent B, that is C2, is equal to KD. The constant KD, or simply K, is called distribution coefficient or partition coefficient or distribution ratio. Then we'll see solubility and distribution law. When a solute is taken with two immiscible solvents, at an equilibrium both solvents are saturated with solute. Since the solubility also represents concentration, we can write the distribution law as C1 divided by C2 is equal to S1 divided by S2 is equal to KD. Means concentration of solute X in a solvent A is equal to solubility of that particular solvent into the solute A. Same is the case for the C2, means concentration is same as that of the solubility of particular solvent in the particular solute into the solvent. Then S1 and S2 are solubilities of solute in two solvents. Hence, knowing the value of distribution coefficient and solubility of solute in one of the solvent, the solubility of solute in second solvent can be calculated. Then more explanation for the distribution law. This distribution law is also known as the equilibrium law. When distribution of solute X has reached dynamic equilibrium, the rate at which the molecule X passes from solvent A to B is proportional to the concentration C1 in A. Then the rate R2 at which molecules of X passes from B to A. R1 is the rate of distribution or rate of transfer of this X molecules from A to B, while R2 is the rate of transfer of X molecule from B to A, is proportional to its concentration C2, and also at equilibrium rate of migration of solute from one solvent to another is equal. This is the Nernst distribution law equation. Since K1 and K2 are constant at same temperature, the distribution coefficient Kd is also constant if temperature is fixed. This is the solvent A, solvent B. C1 is the concentration in solvent A, C2 is concentration into B. Then movement of the molecules or the rate of transfer of molecule from A to B, that is the R1, and movement of the molecule from B to A, that is the R2. Then R1, as per the statement, R1 is directly proportional to the C1, means concentration of the molecule into the A solvent. Then we can rearrange this equation. R1 is equal to K1 into C1, whereas K1 is the constant. Similarly, you can write for the R2. R2 is directly proportional to the concentration, that is C2, means rate of transfer of molecule from B to A. Then R2 is equal to K2 into C2, where K2 is the constant. Then R1 at the equilibrium condition, R1 is equal to R2. That's why K1 into C1 is equal to K2 into C2. That's why C1 upon C2 is equal to K2 upon K1 is equal to Kd. This is the derivation of this Nernst distribution law. How it will become C1 upon C2 is equal to Kd. Now we'll move to the limitation of this distribution law. First, that is the constant temperature. The temperature is kept constant throughout the experiment, then this law is applicable. Otherwise, the variation of concentration is there in the two solvent of solute. Same molecular state, the molecular state of solute is same in two solvent. The law does not hold if there is a association and dissociation of solute in one of the solvent. Means there is no association and dissociation or interaction of solute molecule with these solvent. The molecular state of your solute should be same in both the type of the solvent. This is the second limitation. Then equilibrium concentration. The concentration of solute annotated after equilibrium has been established. Then fourth, dilute solutions. The concentration of solution in the two solvent is low. The law does not hold when concentration are high. Okay, means concentration of solute in two solvent is low. The law does not hold when concentration are high. Okay, non-miscibility of solvent. The two solvent are non-miscible or only slightly soluble in each other, the extent of mutual solubility of solvent remain unaltered by addition of solute to them. then application of this distribution law, solubility of drug in water and other solvent can be predicted by using distribution law. Whether your drug is lipophilic or hydrophilic, you can determine by using this distribution law. Then extraction of drug from biological fluid such as blood, tissue, urine can be obtained sufficiently. Then effective concentration of preservative can be predicted for storage of emulsion and other dosage form. Then drug absorption in vivo can be predicted. The N-octanol water partitioning system mimic the lipid membrane water system found in the body. Release of drug from ointment and cream can be predicted. Means how the drug released from the dosage form is determined by using this distribution law. The drug content of pharmacodynamics. What drug does to the body. How drug affect on the body. The hydrophobic effect is major driving force for binding of the drug to the receptor target. It is advisable to make the drug as hydrophilic as possible while it still retain adequate binding affinity to therapeutic protein target. Means it should have good solubility, that's why it should have some hydrophilic property, and your drug should also have the hydrophobic property for the binding of the protein, for binding of the target molecule. This can be achieved by using the distribution law. This is all about the NERSC distribution law. Thank you.